Before 1956, that is before Jimmy Smith hit the national jazz scene like a Titan missile takeoff, the organ had been one of jazz's poor relations. The strong men of the instrument were Wild Bill Davis, Bill Doggett, Jackie Davis, and precious few others. Although these men had their loyal followers, they were never able to break through to the mass of jazz lovers. And certainly the modern jazz fan, weaned on Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, and Thelonious Monk, considered them somewhere beyond the pale. Until Jimmy Smith's arrival, this had been the story of jazz organ, since the late Fats Waller and Count Basie. They had adopted the instrument as a sort of sideline for kicks. Well, to Jimmy Smith, the organ was no mere kicks instrument. From the time he first heard Wild Bill Davis in 1953, he says he was sold. From his earnings as a pianist around Norristown, Pennsylvania, where he was born, Jimmy saved the money for a down payment on a Hammond. And by the summer of 1955, after only 3 or 4 months of teaching himself, he came out wailing. Jazz has never been quite the same since. For further confirmation of that statement, listen now to Jimmy pay his respects to an arch villain, Mac the Knife. Thank you. This is one of more than 20 albums Jimmy Smith has recorded for Blue Note Records in recent years. And this, on the Verve label, showcases Jimmy backed by a big band playing Oliver Nelson's arrangements. Both records, in fact, all his records, reveal the one element that is stamped on Jimmy's jazz character. Critics have used terms such as fiery enthusiasm and relentless drive to describe this element. However one may put it in words, this quality is very much Jimmy Smith. Here it is again, right now, with Jimmy. Quentin Warren on guitar, and Donald Bailey on drums, in what promises to be a very wild wind-up to this meeting. A roaring takeoff on Dizzy Gillespie's The Champ. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.